showing you how to make atirasam or kajjaya. This is one of the traditional sweets. To make this atirasam or kajjaya, we need 1 cup rice. You have to wash thoroughly and soak it in the water. I soak this in the night, so at least it has to soak for 3 to 4 hours. Little bit of cardamom powder, 1/2 cup of jaggery, around 1/4 cup of water. First we have to drain this water thoroughly and spread it on a towel for about 30 to 40 minutes. It should not be dried completely. The rice has to have some moisture in it to grind it. So spread like this on a towel or a paper towel. We have this dried rice, but it still has some moisture in it, so we need that moisture. I'm going to grind it to a fine powder. It has to be like this, fine powder. We have this powder ready. To this flour, add this cardamom powder and mix it well. Heat the jaggery and the water on medium heat. If you feel the jaggery has impurities, then strain it through a clean cloth and keep it back on the stove on a medium heat. Important thing in doing this kajjaya or atirasa is the consistency of this jaggery syrup. To check this, add a little bit of jaggery syrup into a water, bowl of water. So you should be able to make a soft ball. If you cannot make it, then the consistency is not right. After a few minutes, I am trying it again. Put a little bit of jaggery syrup into the water. And now I will be able to make this soft ball, as you see here. Now this syrup is ready. I'm going to add the flour. The flour you have to add little by little. You don't have to add all the flour at once. And mix it well. We may not even use all the flour which we made. So maybe a tablespoon or two is left. If we use more jaggery, the kajjaya will disintegrate. If we use less jaggery, the kajjaya will become hard. After we get the right consistency, I'm going to add this little bit of oil, like 1/2 teaspoon of oil, and mix it well. And this has to be the consistency. Now turn off the heat and let it cool. I'm going to grease this container with a little bit of oil or ghee. I'm using ghee here. So I'm going to transfer this to this container. And I'm going to put 1 teaspoon of oil on top of it and keep it for 24 hours minimum. You can keep this for 2 to 3 days and then you can make a kajjayas. And no need to refrigerate the dough. I made it 2 days ago. I have this dough now. It has to be like a chapati dough, like this. If it is little bit watery, you can add either rice flour or maida to this and mix it and make it like a chapati dough. If it is very hard after 2 days, you can add a little bit of water and again you can mix it and make it like a chapati dough. I'm going to keep the oil on medium heat. I have this plastic sheet. I'm going to grease this. Grease your hands too. Then take a tablespoon or 1 1/2 tablespoon of this dough, make it a circle and press it to make a circle. Don't make it too thin, it has to be thick like this. If you don't want to use this plastic sheet, you can do it on your palm too, like this. Remember, don't keep the oil on very high or very low heat. Medium heat is enough. Now the oil is hot enough. To check, I'm going to add a little bit of this dough. It has to come up immediately. I'm going to put this into this hot oil. This will puff up like a puri. Flip it to the other side. It has to turn this color, golden brown. Now it turned golden brown on both the sides. Take this and press it like this to remove excess oil. And I'm going to put it on the paper towel. Grease the plastic sheet once in a while and continue the same procedure with the remaining dough. Now I have this atirasam or kajaya is ready. We can make around 10 to 12 atirasa with 1 cup of rice. As I said, the consistency of the jaggery syrup is very important here. So make sure you get that consistency. I hope you enjoy making this atirasam or kajaya. For more recipes, please visit our website at foodandremedy.com. Thank you.